Takahiro.
Tangaroa Te Tai.
Karite.
Possibly a name we back home aren't too familiar with. When I lost my mind. Does that make me crazy? But across the ditch, he's known as Big T, and the Aussies go crazy over him. And it's all thanks to his meteoric rise to fame on the world's biggest reality talent competition.
Yeah, it was pretty frightening when I stepped onto the X Factor stage. You know, I was backstage and I was like, this is the time I shine. This is the little Māori boy from Te Rite North about to walk in the front of a Hall of Australia. And, you know, as soon as the music played... I felt comfortable, it felt right, and it felt like I was meant to be there. Heartbeat, I'm maxing you, but I'm too shy, can't you see? You know, to be honest, I've always had a dream to be on the X Factor stage. You know, watching X Factor as a child back home in New Zealand, like I always known that I wanted to be on the Australian X Factor. Come on, woo, let's get it on. New Zealand didn't have an X Factor when I went back home, so...
They had Hōmai Te Paki Paki.
They did have Hōmai Te Paki Paki, and I was on that. Hōmai.
Bigger than X Factor.
Bigger. It's international. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid us of a vanity
and disco is the seasons. It's what we aim to do. And how did you do on that show?
Terrible.
Was it in the place?
I came third on Hōmai Te Paki Paki and... Yeah, I enjoyed myself. It was cool. Good old karaoke. You can't beat it.
And just like Hōmai, there was an audition process for X Factor. Big T knew he had to nail.
Yeah, on my audition day, I flew straight from the mines. Woke up in the morning, I saw my Hi-Vis uniform on the ground, and I was like, I'm going to wear that today, and, you know, I got it right here with me.
So is that your good luck charm?
Yeah, you could say it's my good luck charm, but I think I just felt comfortable, you know. I was an everyday worker and loved my job, but wanted to do something that I loved more, which was singing. Something that I'm passionate about and that I want to do for the rest of my life. Being on the X Factor was a lot of hard work, not only hard work, but being away from my partner, being away from my family. You know, I'm isolated in Sydney, like, in a hotel and working hard every day, but at the end of the day, I knew it was a dream and it's going to take hard work to fulfill your dream.
And helping him fulfill that dream was his mentor, Chris Isaac, who helped Big T make it all the way to the top four.
T finally has a song that he knows. And now all he's got to do on the night is tell us the story.
Big T! Chris Isaac's amazing, you know. What you see on camera is what you get off camera. Like, when I got kicked off the X Factor, or not kicked off, but voted off, he took me into his room, no cameras around, nothing. Again, he gave me this beautiful guitar, got right next to me.
Wow.
And, yeah, that just explains the man he is. Big T, your musical journey is just starting out, but a guy with that voice, that heart, you are going to have a ball. I love you, Big T, your singing power, Chris Isaac. You know, being Māori is definitely a part of my success and how I am today. Just a humble boy, you know, grew up in New Zealand and doing kapa haka for a living and, you know, coming onto a stage, training me there. But I know that my hometown, my home country is behind me 100%.
And speaking of home, Big T has a final message for all of us back in Aotearoa.
Yeah, just a message to all the whānau back home, especially to the next generation. If you've got a dream, fulfill it, and you know anything in life is possible. And if you want to book me in, Big T Booking, hit me up. I want to come back home and put on a massive show.